and see the light in me. I hope to change lives and help make their lives worth living through my life. I will continue to read His Word and receive more of the Holy Spirit in my life and become closer to Him. I won't forget my teachings that I've received throughout my life, and I hope to use them in every aspect of my life. While attending Columbia College Chicago, I hope to build strong relationships and work hard in school. I will use this scholarship award that I've received to enhance my learning experience and work with my greatest potential at the forefront. I will attend church also while away. I am confident and know everything will work out because my life is in God's hands. Just like the scripture says in Romans 8 and 28, and we know that God works all things together for the good of those who love the Lord, who are called according to His purpose. Thank you, Sister Smith and committee, for the opportunity to speak. Thank you, everyone, for listening, and God bless you.
Beautiful, beautiful. Let's all give her a hand clap.
Man.
My God.
Beautiful. Amen.
Yes, yes. And we believe, Sister Madison, that you're going to hold fast to the teachings that you received. Wonderful. All right, next in line is Timothy T.J. Smith, Jr. Let's hear from him.
Hello, everyone. My name is Timothy Smith, Jr., and I attend New Life Community Church of God in Christ, where my pastor is Auxiliary Bishop Timothy Smith, Sr., and the First Lady is Evelyn Smith. And how I plan to hold on to the teachings that I was taught as a child is to pray every day when I first wake up and thank the Lord for waking me up on this morning, because I know that there's a lot of people who didn't get that same opportunity. So that's why I would want to pray to the Lord every day when I first wake up. I also plan on attending church on Zoom virtually every Sunday, so that way I can hold on to the teachings and learn more about our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And I also plan on attending Sunday school every Sunday as well, on virtually, so that way I won't miss church and won't miss Sunday school. And I also plan on not stepping into the wrong crowd, because if you step on into the wrong crowd, you can basically not be a follower of God anymore, if you step into the wrong crowd and bad things can happen. So that's what I plan on doing, is not stepping into the wrong crowd. And one more thing I plan on doing to hold on to the teachings that I learned as a child is to plan on getting baptized and filled with the precious gift of the Holy Ghost soon, so that way I can even have a closer relationship with God. And I just want to thank Sister Christine Smith for this opportunity, for the award, and thank you to the committee for the opportunity for this award as well. I thank my parents for raising me to be a child of God. I thank them so much. And I thank them for putting me in church as well. So thank you, everyone, and may God bless you all.
Beautiful. My Amen. God. Beautiful. Thank
Amen.
God.
Amen.
So I'll give him a great big amen.
Amen.
Also, amen. TJ, we hold you all up in prayer, so we're going to be praying with you that you receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost. And that is so important, as you said. Wonderful, TJ. All right, our last person is Deanna Wells. Let's hear from Deanna.
Amen.
Hello, Sister Smith. This is Tanya Wells. Deanna was on here, and I don't see her anymore. I know she she was also doing some mandatory things this morning at school. She is actually on campus. And so I had her send me this in case we had this problem. So I'm going to read for Deanna because I don't see her on this Zoom anymore. I apologize. Here's what she sent to me. She said, "Hello, I am Deanna Wells. Sorry, I am unable to attend due to mandatory college events. I am currently a student at Washington University in St. Louis, majoring in biology on the pre-med track. I will hold true to the values I was taught by living according to the fruits of the spirits, taking part in daily prayer and repenting when I recognize things I have done wrong. Overall, I believe the most important way to hold to these teachings I receive is to exhibit the fruits of the spirits, as they not only apply to the way in which one lives, but also the way one treats those around them. Throughout the rest of my academic career, I plan to showcase the fruits: love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Loving my neighbors, finding and spreading joy throughout my day-to-day life, making peace with those who are different from myself, patience when conflict arises, kindness when others are in need, goodness by showing empathy, faithfulness in my commitment to Christ, gentleness in the things I say, self-control by not straying from my beliefs. Thank you, Sister Smith, and the EMWI Women's Department for this book scholarship opportunity. Thank you, my family, for keeping me in church."
Amen. Thank you, Sister Wells, for reading that for Deanna. We did see her online, and she did let us know ahead of time that she had mandatory obligations on the Washington U campus. And so we just want all of you all, we thank God for the parents who raise these children up in the church. And we want to thank each and every one of us. And listen, remember to hold them up in prayer. More so than anything else, they need Christ in their life. And they need the baptism of the Holy Ghost. And so encourage them to stay in Sunday school, to stay faithful to their church in some type of Bible study weekly. They need their church. All right, so we're going to move right along. It's hopefully I can go through this more expediently. We had our history of the St. Carrie Dinwiddie Education Award. You will see this on our website. Is someone trying to get my attention? All right, so next we're going to have the presentation from missionary Carolyn Gardner of our St. Carrie Dinwiddie Award. Let me stop sharing my screen for a second here so she can see. We can see her.
Are we ready?
Yes.
Good morning, everyone. On behalf of Mother Watts and the EMWI Departments of Women, we will present the Mother St. Carrie Dinwiddie Award to First Lady Deborah Quarles for her commitment to education and work in the Department of Women on a local, district, and jurisdictional level. Through inspirational and scholastic endeavors, they are helping to win souls for Christ, to empower families, and ultimately impact their community. Their efforts to prepare and mentor countless people to enhance their spiritual, educational, and professional experience. We salute their dedication to Bishop Wooten's good, better, best motto. In 1984, Evangelist Deborah Quarles accepted Christ as the Lord and Savior of her life and receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Evangelist Quarles is First Lady of Thermostat, Church of God in Christ, and Bethel Church of God in Christ, under the leadership of her pastor and husband of 42 years, the Assistant Superintendent Charles Quarles Sr. At the recommendation of Bishop Timothy Smith, Superintendent of the Walter E. Donelson District, she was appointed district missionary by Mother Rosetta Watts, supervisor of women for the Eastern Missouri, Western Illinois jurisdiction. Evangelist Deborah Quarles serves as a licensed evangelist missionary in the EMWI jurisdiction. She has committed and dedicated her life to the work of the Lord. She has provided leadership and support in serving in the following local offices: President, Women's Department, President of the Hospitality Unit, Vice President of Sunshine Band, Choir Member, Assistant Cotillion Coordinator, and President of the Marriage Ministry. She also served on the following committees and boards: Missions, Finance, Food Pantry, Pastor's Aid, Intercessory Prayer, and Mother's Board on the district level. Evangelist Deborah Quarles oversees the Department of Women as district missionary. She has established the Women of Excellence Ministry, designed to equip, teach, and empower women to make foolproof of their ministry, thus becoming women of excellence. On the jurisdictional level, Evangelist Deborah Quarles serves on the Program Committee, Co-Coordinator of the District Missionary Unit, Directory Committee Coordinator, Auxiliaries, Bands, Circles, and Units Coordinator for the EMWI Department of Women. On the international level, she serves on the Membership Committee on the International District Missionary Unit. She is an entrepreneur. She received a Bachelor of Science degree in 2018 from St. Louis University. She is currently pursuing a second Bachelor of Arts degree in Organizational Study at St. Louis University. With that being said, it gives me great honor to present the Mother St. Carrie Dinwiddie Award to Evangelist District Missionary Deborah Quarles. And this is the award that we are presenting to Evangelist Deborah Quarles. Amen?
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Could she hold that up a little bit further up so we can see the entire plaque? Hold it up a little bit higher. There you go. Thank you.
You're welcome. Can everyone see it?
Yes. Yes. Read it to us.
Yes.
Yeah. Huh?
What does the plaque say?
It says, EMWI Women's Convention presents Deborah Quarles 2021 St. Carrie Dinwiddie Educational Achievement Award, Mother Rosetta Watts, Supervisor, and Bishop Lawrence Wooden, Prelate.
Thank you. Thank you. Wonderful, wonderful. Congratulations, Sister Quarles. And at this time, we're going to leave room for you to give remarks.
Amen. I certainly honor the Lord on this morning, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We honor our Prelate Bishop Lawrence M. Wooten, second presiding bishop. We also honor our supervisor, Mother Rosetta Watts, executive board member of the International Women's Department. And we honor the fragrance of our jurisdiction, First International Evangelist Lady Shirley Wooten, We thank God for my superintendent and First Lady of District 10, Bishop Timothy Smith and Lady Evelyn Smith. We thank God for you on today. And I honor my pastor, my superintendent, my husband, my assistant superintendent, my husband, Charles Quarles, who has allowed me to serve in the capacities that I serve in. We honor the chairperson of the Education Committee, Evangelist Christine Smith. And last but not least, we honor my very own assistant district missionary, Mother Carolyn Gardner, who saw fit to nominate me as to be a recipient of this great award. And you know, what I do to the glory of God. And I love serving God's people and helping wherever I can, both local, district, and in the Department of Women, just carrying out the vision of my leaders. So I thank God for you on today. Thank God for each of you, the Education Committee. Praise God, praise God. I thank God for this great, great award. I never would have even imagined me getting the Mother St. Carrie Dinwiddie Education Award, but I thank God, and to God be the glory. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Evangelist Quarles. I am steady letting people in, so you all forgive me. But right now, we would like to hear the history. Now, Sister Evangelist Beverly Sanders, I believe she gave us the history of St. Carrie Dinwiddie, but she did not give us how. How do some of you may be asking, how can I be a recipient of the St. Carrie Dinwiddie Award? And so she's going to give us the qualifications for receiving the St. Carrie Dinwiddie Award. Evangelist Beverly Sanders.
Amen. Thank you, Missionary Smith. When it comes to the qualifications for this distinguished award, this Mother St. Carrie Dinwiddie Award, Education Award, I should say, the first qualification is one must be a born-again Christian. One must be saved. We ask that they submit a resume with the academic achievements, and which would list their professional development awards, awards that were provided for excellence in voluntary activities, whether they be in the church or in the community, in community service. Those that have a professional development awards, academic achievement, outstanding achievement in the Church of God in Christ, EMWI jurisdiction, and the national, if applicable. These are individuals who have impacted others by their efforts and willingness to support and mentor others in their pursuit of college and or career aspirations. So we're looking for change agents, those that have made a difference in others' lives. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Evangelist Sanders. And this will be posted on our EMWI, Department of Women Education Committee website. All right. At this time, I believe we have completed all of our awards. We don't want to hold you any longer than necessary. We want to see if our supervisor, Mother Rosetta Watts, if she is on the line or sent a representation in her place. All right, and we know the situation that's going on with her. So we thank God for her. We thank, and you all pray that we've been trying to get Mother to name our EMWI Book Scholarship Award after her, because she was the one that kind of started this book scholarship for our senior high school students, but she said no. So we're going to be praying to that end. Right now we're just calling it the EMWI Department of Women Book Scholarship Award. All right, and also we want to see if our second assistant of the Church of God in Christ, Bishop Lawrence M. Wooten, did he send someone in his place, or is he on the line to give remarks? All right, with that being all, I think the only bishop is Bishop Nelson Watts on the line. All right, so I'll just read this thanks and dedication. We would like to express thanks to First God, to the EMWI Education Committee, to the EMWI Professional Business Women 8th District that has also contributed to our awards, and our state supervisor, Mother Rosetta Watts, who contributed out of her own pocket to these rewards for their dedicated service. We thank our EMWI jurisdictional Bishop Lawrence M. Wooten, our parents, family, and friends for all their love and support. Thank you all for sharing this special day with all the recipients. And with that being said, we can have our closing prayer by our Bishop Timothy Smith. Auxiliary Bishop Timothy Smith, could you give us our closing prayer, please?
Amen, amen. Just bow your heads as we go to the Lord in prayer on this morning. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your goodness, your mercy, your many blessings. God, we thank you for what has been done on today. Thank you, Lord. God, we thank you for these scholarships recipients. God, we thank you for the District Missionary Calls and the St. Carrie Dinwiddie Award winner that she is. God, we thank you for Evangelist Smith and all those that work with her, Lord. Now, Father, as we leave this meeting, God, we ask that you be with these young people on the college campuses, keep them, lead them, guide them, and direct them. Father, we ask that you be with all of us, keep us safe, keep us covered under the blood, bless our worship services on tomorrow. And God, we'll be sure to give you all the praise, all the glory, and all the honor in Jesus' name. Thank God. Amen. God bless you, saints.
Amen.
And saints, we didn't give our parents a time to say anything. Does any of the parents have anything they would like to say before we leave?
Amen. God bless you. It's Superintendent Sanders, and I apologize for getting on my wife's camera. But yes, we like to say how much we appreciate the committee, and we thank God for each of you, and thank God for our daughter Madison, who has worked very hard. The Lord has blessed her, and I think it's important, as we have forestated, to ensure our young people are filled with the Holy Ghost, because the Holy Ghost is what's really going to keep them. So we give God the praise for them. I want to encourage the committee to keep doing what you're doing. A lot of people forget young people, but we thank God for you. Even the smallest amount is very appreciated. And so we give God a praise for you.
Amen.
Lady Sanders.
Amen. Amen. Just want to echo, thank you so much. I appreciate the fact how education is really a forefront in our jurisdiction. That is so key and so vital. So thank you again so much.
Amen. Anyone else before we close out?
Evangelist Smith, this is District Missionary Qualls again. I just want to just encourage the young people to remain steadfast and unmovable in all, you know, in their education. Don't let nothing deter you. Be determined. Keep God at the forefront. And one thing I did while I'm in college, one thing that I do while I'm in college is I search out scholarships. So each college should have a scholarship suite where you can go out there and put in for different scholarships. They have one available for you. And so that's what I did in my while I'm in college. I'm a little bit older than you, a whole lot older than you guys, but you know, just remain on the course. Don't let nothing stop you from getting your education. Amen.
Thank you, Evangelist First Lady Qualls, for that, because I think that is something that we as African Americans overlook sometimes. We need to search out these scholarships. They're out there for us. And sometimes our children are saying they're so hard to find. You have to search diligently. They are out there for us.
Yes, yes.
Anyone else?
Hello, this is Tanya Wells. I just wanted to say thank you very much for this opportunity for my, I'm speaking on behalf of my daughter who had to drop off the call, but I just want to say thank you for all that you do with the youth. Thank you, EMWI, for considering even having a scholarship to assist the young people in their endeavors. And I just wanted to say how grateful we are to be a recipient of this scholarship, as well as giving this opportunity to speak. So just want to say thanks to everyone.
Amen. God bless you, Evangelist Christine Smith. This is Lady Smith. First, I wanted to say congrats to all of those youth, the scholarship recipients. All of them have done well. Sister Madison, Deanna, and Timothy Smith, I believe their grades were outstanding. So we just want to, you know, congratulate all of the young people. As Pastor Avery Sanders, Superintendent Sanders said, you know, sometimes people forget young people, and I'm a big supporter of young people and youth. So we just want to congratulate them, and we just want to say to all of the young people, stay with God, put God first in everything that you do, and make sure that you keep God the center of your life. And I just wanted to say congratulations to Evangelist Christine Smith. Evangelist Smith is doing an outstanding job. She has done an outstanding job for years. And we thank and praise God for her full support of those who are in education. And we just thank and praise God for her leadership. If I could write her a check today, I would write a great big check for all that she does. But I know that she does this. This is something that she has a passion for, and this is something that God gave her because she has stuck with this for many, many years. So we praise God for her leadership and those who work with her, Lady A, Lady Sanders, Beverly Sanders, and the entire committee, and to Mother Watts, who fully supports our young people with scholarships and money out of her pocket. We just praise God for her, and we praise God for our district missionary, how the Lord has blessed her to matriculate and go on higher to receive all that God would have for her to be. So we congratulate her as well. And I just want to say, you know, just keep doing what you're doing. Evangelist Smith, I just want to encourage you. God sees what you're doing. He knows your heart, and he knows that you have the heart for education and the heart for our youth. And God is going to reward you for your labor. This is, to you, your labor is not in vain. You know, even though people may not understand it, people may not fully support what God has given you, but know that this is a God-given assignment and your work is not in vain. And those young people that are recipients of this reward, of those who have been past recipients, they're going to remember that you sowed into their life, that you sowed into their education, and they're going to remember that. So we do thank and praise God for you. And we just want to say, keep doing what you're doing, because God is getting all the glory and all the honor and all the praise. And God bless you.
Amen. Amen. Anyone else before we have remarks? Let me just say this, saints. I found something this morning that made me my heart so glad. I smiled from ear to ear. There was our first recipient of the Save Our Seed Outreach Scholarship to a young lady by the name of Rebecca Johnson. This young lady has her doctorate's degree now. She has her own nonprofit organization, and she's giving scholarships out to seniors. And so I posted on Facebook in our education department, I believe, Save Our Seed. No, it's a Save Our Seed website. So you can find that little clip about her. She's a very particular, well, what is the word I'm looking for? Can't think of the word, but she is an excellent example of what we were looking for, someone to give back. You know, she received a $500 scholarship, and now she is rewarding all high school, and she took it on a level that I'll probably never reach. If you look at her board, she has all doctors and people with degrees on her board. And so she's just doing an excellent job, and I was so proud of her. Thank you all so much for tuning in with us. And God bless you. Have a wonderful Saturday. And that's it from the Education Committee. We want to thank each and every member of the Education Committee. God bless.
God bless you.
God bless the saints.
God bless you.
Yes.